the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, as we gather together to celebrate the third Sunday of Easter, let us acknowledge our sin and so prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the heavens.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. May your people exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our redemption, we may go forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice and proclaimed, "You who are Jews, indeed all of you, staying in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to my words. You who are Israelites, hear these words. Jesus the Nazarene was a man commended to you by God with mighty deeds, wonders, and signs, which God worked through him in your midst, as you yourself know. This man delivered up by the set plan and foreknowledge of God, you killed using lawless men to crucify him. But God raised him up, releasing him from the throes of death, because it was impossible for him to be held by it. For David says of him, 'I saw the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand I shall not be disturbed. Therefore my heart has been glad, and my tongue has exulted. My flesh too will dwell in hope, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence.' My brothers, one can confidently say to you about the patriarch David that he died and was buried, and his tomb is in our midst to this day. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn an oath to him, that he would set one of his descendants upon his throne, he foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of the Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the netherworld, nor did his flesh see corruption. God raised this Jesus, and of this we are all witnesses, exalted at the right hand of God. He received the promise of the Holy Spirit from the Father and poured him forth as you see and hear." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, you will show us the path of life.
Lord, you will show us the path of life.
Keep me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, my Lord are you. O Lord, my allotted portion and my cup. It is you who hold fast my life.
Lord, you will show us the path of life.
I bless the Lord who counsels me. Even in the night my heart exhorts me. I set the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand I shall not be disturbed.
Lord, you will show us the path of life.
Therefore my heart is glad and my soul rejoices. My body too abides in confidence, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your faithful one to undergo corruption.
Lord, you will show us the path of life.
You will show me the path to life, abounding joy in your presence, the delights at your right hand forever.
Lord, you will show us the path of life.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, if you invoke as Father, him who judges impartially, according to each one's works, conduct yourself with reverence during the time of your sojourn, realizing that you were ransomed from your futile conduct, handed on by your ancestors, not with perishable things like silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a spotless, unblemished lamb. He is known before the foundations of the world, but revealed in the final time for you, who through him believe in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
That very day, the first day of the week, two of Jesus' disciples were going to a village 7 miles from Jerusalem, called Emmaus. As they were conversing about all the things that had occurred, and it happened that while they were conversing and debating, Jesus himself drew near and walked with them, but their eyes were prevented from recognizing him. He asked them, "What are you discussing as you walk along?" They stopped, looking downcast. One of them, named Cleopas, said to him in reply, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know the things that have taken place here in these days?" And he replied to them, "What sort of things?" They said to him, "The things that happened to Jesus the Nazarene, who was a prophet mighty in deed and word, before God and all the people, how our chief priests and rulers both handed him over to a sentence of death and crucified him. But we were hoping that he would be the one to redeem Israel. And beside all this, it is now the third day since this took place. Some women from our group, however, have astounded us. They were at the tomb early in the morning, and they did not find his body. They came back and reported that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who announced that he was alive. Then some of those with us went to the tomb and found things just as the women had described, but him they did not see. And he said to them, 'Oh, how foolish you are, how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets spoke. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory?' Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them what referred to him in all the scriptures. As they approached the village to which they were going, he gave the impression that he was going on further. But they urged him, 'Stay with us, for it is nearly evening, and the day is almost over.' So he went in to stay with them. And it happened that while he was with them at table, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them. With that, their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, but he vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, 'Were not our hearts burning within us, while he spoke to us on the way and opened the scriptures to us?' So they set out at once and returned to Jerusalem, where they found gathered together the 11 and those with them who were saying, "The Lord truly has been raised and appeared to Simon." Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way, and how he was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The other day I was talking to a friend. He's going to be 88 in September, and he was talking about how he can't believe when he goes to the grocery store how things aren't on the shelves, how there's a shortage. And he says it reminds me of when I was younger and World War II was going on, and he would go to the grocery store for his mother on Parade Street, and there would be a lot of things that you couldn't get. And I was just thinking, in his almost 88 years of life, the many things that he's seen, the joys, the sorrows, and we can think about in our own lives, whether you're 48, 70, 21, whatever the age, what we have seen in our lifetime, what we have experienced, the joys and sorrows. The gospel today is the journey to Emmaus. And the journey to Emmaus could be seen as our journey, our life's journey. And we look at the disciples in the gospel today, they're going home. They've been disappointed. The person they put all their faith and trust into, Jesus Christ, was crucified. And probably we can relate to how they felt. What did it say in the gospel? They were downcast. What things in our lives have caused us maybe to want to walk away? Maybe we've gone through a divorce. We've been hurt by a close friend, betrayed. Maybe we've been hurt by the church. And many times we say, enough, that's it. I'm walking away. And what happens, and many times we may say we're walking away because we don't feel that Jesus is near me. He's not listening to my prayers in this time of need. But we look to the scriptures. And when they were downcast, when they were feeling alone, who was with them? Jesus. But they didn't recognize him. And why didn't they recognize him? Because their hearts were closed. When did they start to recognize Jesus? It wasn't until the end when they said to him, "Stay with us." Then all of a sudden, they opened their hearts. And it's in the breaking of the bread that they recognize Jesus. And then they say, "Weren't our hearts burning as he explained the scriptures to us?" So those are two important lessons for us, all of us, whether we're priest, religious, layperson, old, young, middle age, is that the sacraments are so important. That's where we encounter Christ. And we probably realize that now more than ever. When we've been hurt, when we're feeling alone, we need the sacraments, because that's where Christ is present. Many times as we go through life, we don't think he's there. We can't feel him. But it's in the breaking of the bread, the Eucharist, when we receive our risen Lord, that our eyes are open and we see his presence. Jesus is the consummate teacher. He's the teacher par excellence. He knows that they don't understand. So what does he do? He takes the time and explains the scriptures to them. He starts all over again. When I was in seminary, I had to take Greek, an upper level Greek course at St. Vincent. And I remember I took the introductory level when I was an undergraduate at Gannon, and I learned nothing. I didn't have a very good teacher and whatever. And so I was very nervous about taking this Greek class, and Father Faye was a very good teacher. And I remember saying to him, "Father, I haven't had Greek in 3 years, and I didn't have a very good teacher." He said, "Don't worry, I assume nothing, and I start from the beginning." And I thought, what a good teacher. He assumes nothing, and he starts from the beginning. And how patient he was with us. And we see that with Jesus. How patient he is with us. when we don't totally understand. So as we continue our journey to Emmaus, as we continue our journey through life, think of the disciples in the gospel today, and think of how they began to recognize Jesus. First, we need to open our hearts to Jesus, now more than ever. When we're feeling abandoned, lonely, or if we've been hurt, open our hearts to Jesus. Stay close to the sacraments. Pray the scriptures, read the scriptures, because then we will see him, and then will our hearts burn, because we know he's in our presence. A profession of our faith using the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting.
Amen. With faith and confidence in a loving God, let us present our petitions. For the Church, that like the early disciples, we may testify sincerely to Christ's power over sin and death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase of vocations to the priesthood, religious life, and permanent diaconate, especially from our parishes, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our beloved dead may be rewarded with eternal life in the heavenly kingdom, especially for Donald Sabina, who died this week, and for the living and deceased members of the Cathedral Parish, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the victims of the coronavirus, people affected by the quarantine, doctors and scientists working on a vaccine, that God may watch over them and guide them and bring them comfort, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of all creation, we come before you this day. Hear our petitions and grant them according to your will. For we ask them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual food.
Blessed be God forever. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exalted church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also the gifts we bring, may bear fruit in perpetual happiness, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to proclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to loud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has restored our death, and by rising he restored our life. land every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks for it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim
your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Lawrence, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to our apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you for tuning in and celebrating the Eucharist with us this morning. Just a reminder, at 4 o'clock this afternoon, we will have solemn vespers via Facebook. We, our own Father Pat McCormick, will be presider and homilist, so please tune in and join us. Also, this Wednesday, we'll do the tour of the tower. I'm looking at the producer, if he's saying okay. So after the 7:30 Mass, give us a minute, I'll take my vestments off, and we'll climb up the tower, and you'll be able to see where the bells are, the clock mechanism, and we'll go to the tippy top where you can look out through the windows and see the city of Erie. So Wednesday after the 7:30 a.m. Mass, we'll keep reminding you, but please tune in via Facebook for a tour of the Tower of the Cathedral. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.